Hey guys, so yeah, I got suckered in by the monetization model of Real Racing 3, and I've actually spent real money on Real Racing 3. Not that much, and I've spent about close to like 150 hours, or maybe even more than that, on Real Racing 3. So, spent so much time on this thing, and it makes sense because the way it's structured requires a lot of time to earn a lot of money, to buy new cars, and to purchase upgrades and stuff. The amount of money you earn from races is so minuscule that you have to keep racing and racing and racing. But the sense of progression you get, I think, in Real Racing 3 is great because it keeps rewarding you. You know, if you place at least third place in an event, twice, then you get in a series, then you get rewarded with money. And if you complete a certain percentage of the series, like 25%, then you get rewarded. So there's a great amount of rewards that you get as you play the game. I think that's one of the great things that keeps you coming back to play the game more and more and more and more. But the amount of money you make is so little sometimes. By the time you reach like 30% or 40%, when you have these amazing cars, and the races are harder, but the cars are so much more expensive, and the parts are so much more expensive. But the amount of money you make in those types of races is the same amount. You win a race, you know, 5,000 real money dollars, or 4,000 real money dollars. Just because you're racing a supercar, which costs, I don't know, $800,000, doesn't mean if you race with that, you're not earning like $20,000, $30,000, which is what you should be earning, because the cost of upgrading the parts of that car is ridiculously expensive. No, you're still earning $5,000, $3,000, $2,000, $1,000. So at that point, it becomes kind of a grind fest and a really tedious game of just racing again and again and again and again. It did get to that point. I did end up spending $10 because there was a sale that not an actual sale, but like a sale in the game. Like, you can buy this car 50% off, and it was like, I think it was a $700,000 car. I had like $100,000 or $120,000, and because it was 50% off, I could buy it for $350,000. But I don't have $350,000, I have $110,000. So went to the marketplace and spent $10, got $300,000, and bought the car. And I don't regret it, because it's an awesome car, and I had a good run of it. And at the time, before the update, I bought this car before the update that really changed the progression structure. So that you don't have to unlock each series one by one by one. That was nice, actually. I kind of preferred that. And you don't have to unlock car one by one by one. So I bought that car. I got to that series. I'm just like, holy crap, I'm driving a supercar for the first time ever. The sense of speed was kind of disappointing. But at the same time, like, finally getting to drive a supercar, because I pay for it, and there's still this challenge that I have to keep going. There's still so much money to earn. And when I first got to it, like, wow, you know, it's a sensible pricing structure is kind of how I felt about it. But then I spent about 100 hours in the game, and I realized, like, there's all these cars that are still so out of my reach, because the amount of money that I would need to buy those cars, to get to unlocking those cars, to unlocking the series to unlock those cars, requires a lot of money. A lot of money. And, like, that's when I got to the point, just like, how much money do I need to unlock that series to get to that car? And it's like, holy crap, I need like $2 million. And the amount of time it takes me to earn $100,000 is about an hour. So in order to earn $2 million, I'd have to spend about like 10 hours or 20 hours on this game. Okay, what if I wanted to just buy the car outright with real money? Well, $2 million, let's see, $10 is $300,000. $20 is $700,000. I think $40 is like, no, $30 is like a mil. I forgot how much. But like, in order to get one car, I would have to pay in real money $40 or something, like $50 or something like that. It's at that point I'm just like, this pricing structure is ridiculous. Like, Real Racing 3, I think, overall, is a game that I think I would pay close to $40 or $50 for, because it's an awesome game. But for one car in the game, to get one car in the game, and that's without any upgrades. So, and without any upgrades, because Real Racing 3 is, you play the game based on the series, and each series is based on the type of cars. So you're going to be racing against similar cars without any advantage, without any upgrades. And for a $2 million car, you know the upgrade parts for that car is going to be super expensive. Just for one car to race a couple of series that the car is eligible in requires $50. That's ridiculous. So that's the point where I got to, like, I'm really feel like I don't feel like playing this game anymore. But it's a very rewarding game because it constantly rewards progression. I always liked that about the game. And there's various amounts of, and I just, graphics, the gameplay, it's a great game. And I'm glad I got suckered into paying $10 for it, actually. I don't regret spending $10 on it, because I spent a good amount of time that was well worth more than $10. But at the end of the day, like, just looking at this, the pricing structure overall, it just seems rather ridiculous, you know? Because the amount of time it would take to actually earn that money without spending money is ridiculous. There is an achievement in the game for spending 1,000 hours on the game. 1,000 hours on the game? Yeah, no thank you. I'm not going to spend 1,000 hours on Real Racing 3 alone. I already spent so much time on it. But to expect a player to play 1,000 hours to earn a car is ridiculous. To expect a player to pay $50 to buy one car without any upgrades. So if you wanted to fully upgrade a car, you would probably need to pay about $70 in real money just for one car. It's at that point where Real Racing's freemium model becomes just like, wow, so this is why people hate EA kind of thing. But that's not to say I diss the game. I really enjoy the game. And I think in the lower tier levels, the amount of money that requires you to spend to buy cars or to buy upgrades, like $10 for 300,000 real money, ain't too shabby on the lower tiers. It's when you get to the higher tiers and you realize the cheapest car you can buy on the supercar is $800,000. Again, $20. Is $700,000. So even $20 can't buy you one digital car, one digital item in the game. It's at that point that it gets ridiculous. And it's that point where it's just like, I'm not playing the game. So, yeah. That's my thoughts on the whole Real Racing 3's pricing structure and how I guess I ended up paying $10 for it. So that's my story. Hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.